Hello and welcome to this free training on how to nail your niche the feminine way. My name is Sian Burton and I'm a marketing and business coach to women private practice owners in the allied health space. Today I'm going to be sharing with you some information about what a niche is, what a market is, what an ideal client is, and why that's probably been tripping you up till now. I'm going to share with you five reasons that I believe is of the utmost importance that you have an ideal client and you have a niche that they are in. And finally, I'm going to help you identify your niche and ideal client, even if you have tried to do this many times in the past with no success. I have a few tricks and tips up my sleeve after doing this for nearly 15 years, and I'm confident that we're going to get you some clarity today together if you stay here with me on this training. So let's get started. First things first, I want to talk about the difference between a market, a niche, and an ideal client, because just this jargon can throw people and make it seem way more confusing than it needs to be. So a market is the entire group of people that you can service with your service or offering. So for me, as a business and marketing coach, that is every business owner on the planet. They are my market in its entirety. Obviously, that is huge. For you as a speech pathologist, it is everybody from the baby who is not feeding well through to the stroke survivor who cannot swallow their food. For a physical therapist, it's everybody from the child who's not hitting their milestones through to the hip replacement that needs physical therapy post-surgery. And everywhere in between, for every other allied health profession that is watching this video, you know there's a massive diversity of people you can serve, and you are not here to serve them all. So that is your market. Your niche within that market is a smaller subset of the larger market. So for me, I have focused my niche on private practice owners in the allied health space. Now that is still a massive market, but it is much smaller than business owners as a whole. As a speech pathologist, your niche may be pediatrics. It may be as a physical therapist that you work on teenagers between 12 and 22 who need your support. It might be as an occupational therapist that you work with people who need support with daily living. So you are picking a subset of your bigger market, either by condition, it can be by age, it can be by the kind of support that they need. You're making that big market a bit smaller. Now this is where I've reeled you in with some terms that you think you need, but actually aren't what you need. So most of you are probably thinking, oh, well, I know my niche then. I know I want to focus on adults, or I know I want to focus on kids, or I know I want to focus on this age range or this condition, right? But your marketing is still not landing. And that is because you're not clear on your ideal client within that niche. And this is where people really freak out. It's where it gets scary. It's where people say, oh my goodness, what if I can't attract enough people in that group to make that work? But that is where the magic happens. So for me, I don't service every private practice owner in the allied health space. My ideal client within that niche, within that market, is a woman who has between 2 and 10 team members, who has kids at home and wants more success with less sacrifice. That's my person. So for you, you may have said, well, I want to focus on kids. But the step that you get stuck on is to say that I want to work with kids who cannot pronounce their R's. I have a client in my abundant referrals program and that's all she does. Kids who cannot pronounce their R's and any associated condition that causes that problem. It may be that you say, I want to focus on people with neurological conditions and I want to see them in their own home. That is a very tight niche for a physical therapist or an exercise physiologist, which my husband is. That's the bit where people get scared. But let's talk about the five reasons why it is really, really important that you go there and you select the ideal client within that niche and the difference it can make in your practice when you do so. So, reason number one that I'm going to give you, it's very difficult to be successful when you are dividing your attention. So let's say you have two people that you really, really passionately want to help and you can't decide between the two, so you try and market to both at the same time. Here's why that doesn't work, because many people believe that you're spreading your options, right? And you should be getting referrals in from both places and that should make it easier. But think about it like this. If you have 100 points of effort and you put those 100 points of effort into one type of client, attracting that one ideal client, and let's say that 100 points of effort returns you 100 clients. So it's 100 in, 100 out, right? We're winning. Now the assumption is that if you do 50-50, you will get 50% of the effort going in and 50% of the results coming out. But it simply doesn't work like that. If you put 50 points of energy here and 50 points of energy here, you won't get 50 referrals coming from each side because your energy and your effort is divided. So you're going from here to here to here to here. That takes energy, that's confusing, that takes more creation. You might need 2 websites, you might need 2 leaflets, you might need 2 business cards. Twice as much stuff is going on. That means that you don't actually get as much momentum and as much output because you've doubled the workload. So the 50 points of energy don't create 50 clients back in, they might create 30. And for every division past that, you're dropping down and dropping down the result that you get from that energy input. So what happens if you have 2 people that you really want to work with? Pick one for now. Your ideal client is just for now, it's not forever. If you want to build a 50-50 caseload of 2 client groups, focus on building 1 to 50% first and then moving your attention to building the other 50% later. You will have a much faster result, a much more solid referral base going on if you do that, and you will create much bigger results with more ease. So that's reason number one. You need to know what your niche is so you can focus on one thing and not divide your efforts. Now, reason number two is that when we focus on our ideal client, we let go of all the shoulds, we start to build a practice that is a practice that brings us joy. We start to build a practice that aligns with our values and what we want, not the shoulds of your neighbor or your husband or your father-in-law or someone at a networking event who said, oh, you should be seeing these people. That's a huge opportunity. You can make tons of money. When we seek within ourselves our ideal client and we focus our attention on building that practice, you start to build a practice from a place of joy and abundance and flow, and you have a desire to nurture these people and to collaborate and build community because you have passion behind this group of people. That is what magically grows practices quickly, with ease and flow, in a way that shocks and astounds people, that you just cannot do when you are building a practice based on what you should do, what you've been told is going to work, what you've been told will make you money. You have to know who your ideal client is and what your niche is to tap into that abundance and that flow and that joy and that intuition, that the feminine values that will help you grow a practice you love with ease. That's reason number two. Now, reason number three is that I personally believe you have a moral obligation to be working with these people. That's a big statement. Let me talk a little bit more about it. When you think about someone who is your dream client, you see them in your calendar, you're excited, you're like thinking of all the things you've been reading about in journal articles recently since you last saw them that you want to implement, you've been doing research, you're really keen to see them, see how they've gone, tweak what they're doing. Like, they bring you joy and you would see them for free. When you think about that person, that should light you up. Like, you should feel energized by that person and excited to see them. They deserve that person showing up as their therapist in their session. That's what we all deserve. We deserve to rock up and have somebody truly excited and passionate to support us. Now, if you think about someone on your caseload who you don't feel like that about, not through any fault of your own or their own, maybe they have a condition you're not that excited about or you don't know that much about, maybe they don't gel with you on a personal level, maybe they don't always show up in the way that you would like them to, and if you think about their session, you will feel this like, inside you. That's totally okay. There's not a judgment about how we feel about that person. But what I want you to think about is, in seeing them, because in theory you can help them, you remove their opportunity to find somebody for whom they are an ideal client, for whom is excited to see them, is passionate to help them, knows their condition inside out and back to front, and isn't reading and researching the day before on how they should be treating them. They deserve that. And in seeing them, because they called and you can help, you remove their opportunity to continue on their search to find that therapist. So I truly believe that you have a moral obligation to know who your ideal client is and to turn away anybody who is not your ideal client. That's very scary, I know, particularly if you don't have enough referrals coming in. But trust me, when you really nail this down, you can get those referrals coming in abundance and easily pass off people who are not right for you, knowing you're doing the right thing and that they are going to have a better result as a result of your actions. Okay, so reason number four. This is probably the biggest thing why most people's marketing doesn't work. When you don't know your ideal client, you cannot talk to them in a meaningful way. If I tried to talk to every private practice owner in my niche, everybody from the person on the side who is seeing five clients a week outside of their school contract job, to the corporate practice owner who has 15 practices within their franchise, that is going to make no sense. I can't say anything meaningful that will resonate with both of them because they're living two completely different lives. The same way that you can't say anything meaningful to somebody who has just had a hip replacement as someone whose child is not hitting their milestones. You have to understand who your ideal client is and what they're struggling with, what their hopes and desires are for the future, to be able to say anything meaningful to them that's going to make you stand out. And here's the magic and the trick. People don't want to hear about you. They don't care how long you've been in practice. They don't care how many people work for you. They don't care about your qualifications. They don't care about you at all until they know that you can help them. What they want to know is, can you make me better? Can you take me from where I am right now to where I want to be? And how are you going to do that? And can you do it quickly? And will it work for me? It's all about them. You think about when you buy something, we buy based on what we want and need, not on what the person is selling. This is exactly the same thing. Do not let yourself be tricked into thinking that this is not a purchase. It is 100% a purchase, and it's a very high trust purchase at that. For someone to choose you as their therapist, they need to trust that you can help. And that isn't to do with your qualifications, and it isn't to do with how long you've been in practice. It's to do with their perception that you get them and you understand where they're trying to get to. Because if you can do that, then the assumption is you know how to get them there. And the way that you do this is to get really clear on where that person is now and where they want to be, and to talk that through with them in a way that makes sense. So I call this the Nightmare Island Paradise Cove analogy. Think about them being on Nightmare Island. You might say to them, I can see that you're stuck on this horrible island. The sand is gritty, the water is dirty, there's rubbish everywhere, there's no shade, the sun is beating down on you, there's no food to be had, and you are definitely sure that you saw a shark fin out in the water, so you're not going in there to try and fish, and you wouldn't want to eat any fish out of that water anyway. You're feeling really lonely, really down, and really at a loss as to what your next step is to get off this godforsaken island and get to where you want to be. You thought you were going to be on holiday, for goodness sake. I know what you actually want is to be on a beautiful island with coconuts in the trees, white sandy beaches, turquoise blue water, fresh fish that can be caught to eat, coconut water on tap to be drunk, maybe some cocktails, a beautiful shady leaf over your head, a sun lounger to sit on. That's what Paradise Cove is, and you just landed on the wrong island. Paradise Cove is actually just over the bay, and I have a boat right here that I can take you there if you'd like. My boat is fast, it's safe, I'm an experienced sailor, and I know exactly how to get you there. Would you like to get on board my boat with me to go to Paradise Cove? Imagine now that I switch all that out and I'm talking about where a mum is struggling with her child with autism, talking about where she hopes and dreams they can get to, and the boat bit being that I'm the one that can help them. That's what you need to be able to do to market your practice effectively and to attract these clients to you. And the only way you can do that is if you know who your ideal client is. The fifth and final reason that I really want to share with you about why you need to understand your niche and your ideal client is that every single practice owner I have worked with who hasn't got clear on their niche and is trying to market to be everything to everybody struggles again and again and again to be successful and fill their practice. It's really hard to market a practice when you're trying to talk to everybody because you end up talking to nobody. And to give you some examples of this, I worked with a lady called Tallulah 18 months ago. She'd been trying for a year to grow her practice and was sitting about income of about $1,000 a month. She was working with in a nursing home with adults to keep the money coming in while she tried, but she just couldn't get this practice off the ground. She was marketing for AAC, for swallowing and speech issues in adults, for gender voice realignment for people who had gone through a gender change. She was also talking about general articulation, and she just couldn't get any traction. She fought me, I would think she would agree, on this, on getting onto a niche. She just couldn't. I'd see how this was going to work. It made her really scared and really nervous, and she thought it was going to be the undoing of the work that she'd done. Eventually, I asked her the question that I'm going to ask you shortly to help you identify who your ideal client is. And after 4 weeks of being in the program and talking about all these other people, the thing she came back to me with was the thing she had spoken the least about, and it was to work with people realigning their voice after having gender surgery. We shifted her into that market. I told her to trust me for 2 months and give it a go. 8 weeks later, she was seeing eight clients a week. 6 months later, she had a full caseload and she had eight times her revenue and was still growing. A year and a half later, she now has multiple people working for her and she is the authority in this space. For the whole of the US, people seek her out and ask her to train them on how they can do this better because she is so good at it and she's become so well known for it. That is the magic of nailing your niche and getting super clear on your ideal client within that niche. That is the magic that can happen for you. So if you're listening to this and you're like, that's wonderful, Sian, how the heck do I figure out who my person is? I want you just to take a deep breath. And I want you to answer this question in your own mind. So I want you to imagine that somebody comes to you tomorrow and they tell you that you are never going to be paid for your services ever again. All of your personal needs are going to be taken care of, so you no longer need to work for money. But you are going to need to work 40 hours a week, every week of the year, for the remainder of your life for free. The only thing you get to choose is the group of people that you work with. You get that one choice. So, who is the person that comes to mind? And if no one comes to mind immediately, think back to clients that you've worked with in the past that you would work with for free. If they called you up and said, I really need support, I'm struggling, they didn't have any money, you'd say, you know what, come on in. I love working with you so much, I would work with you for free. Who is that person that you would work with for free, or group of people, or condition? What is that that comes to mind for you? Because that is where your energy and focus should be. Not just for now, not forever, unless you want it to be, but that is the place to start your focus of who your ideal client is and what niche they're in. So, I know you now just have that one thought, that person. What you're going to do in the workbook is to really dig in more and more and more into what that person's hopes and desires and dreams and aspirations are. So you can really start to flesh out who this ideal client is, what they need, what they want, what their nightmare island looks like, so that you can start to talk to them in your marketing about those things and attract that person to you. Now, obviously, this is just on how you get to your niche, so I'm not going to go into the detail of how you communicate that. That's a training for another time. But what I want you to leave today with is a really clear idea of one person in your mind that you've worked with in your past that if you could fill your practice with, you would be overjoyed, and a very clearly outlined specification of their hopes and dreams and fears and aspirations, so that you have that ideal client avatar really, really clear in your mind and know what your niche is, so that you can move forward with confidence into the future knowing that that one thing is nailed down. If you haven't got to that person from this conversation, then there is a short meditation that you can do. It's about 5 to 7 minutes long. You can sit and do that meditation, and it will help you move through a process of finding out who that person is if you haven't come to that person just in this conversation. So you can download that. It's on this page. That will help you too. If you find this really helpful, if I have answered a big question that has been holding you back, if you'd love to know more about how you can write your Nightmare Island to Paradise Cove story for your ideal client, how you can fill your practice with these dream clients without spending money on ads or having to go out and pimp yourself at the local GP surgery, then click the button below to watch the workshop that I have available that talks more about my feminine approach to marketing, more about how you can attract abundant referrals into your practice, and more about how we could possibly work together to achieve that for you too. So I hope you got value from this workshop. I look forward to hearing your feedback. Have a great day. Let me know how you went and your thoughts and who this person is. And I'm excited to see you more in my world soon.